My favorite character is the gingerbread man.
Tiffany Payne always knew her calling to become an educator. But what she never predicted at Lucy Laney Elementary.
Bread. Man, did you use your finger spaces?
Her students would become her teacher.
Yeah. I just love this body of students and this demographic specifically. Read to me what you have. They're just really, they come in really non-judgmental. They come in just ready to learn and ready to receive the love that you have to give to them. Amani, my chair. Abraham, pink chair. Carol, library.
We first met Ms. Payne days before she welcomed her first graders.
It's such an explosion of happiness.
Every corner of her room, Pinterest perfect.
The kids are each going to have different colored book boxes corresponding to
them. I'm so excited.
But a classroom worlds away from her own childhood.
I grew up in Lakeville, out in the country. I was homeschooled till 9th grade. Lakeville's very white, middle class. Everyone pretty much comes from the same cut. And I didn't really know anything else. My parents never really taught anything else because it wasn't really necessary for where I lived.
One, two, three.
And the path that would lead a young teacher to an urban school.
It was like divine intervention, truly.
Would wind through immeasurable grief.
My older brother had a huge heart for the inner city, and he was volunteering in inner city schools. And he asked me, would you ever consider teaching in Minneapolis? And I was like, yeah, right. When I get my degree, I'm heading right back to Lakeville. I'm going to teach in Lakeville. I'm going to teach in a suburb. And then he actually passed away suddenly in a car accident. And it was just so impressed on my heart, Minneapolis. If it weren't for his passing, I wouldn't be here. You know, I call it beauty from ashes. That a dime is worth 10 cents.
Yes.
When I transferred schools after my brother passed away and I was in class and we were talking about white privilege, and I just scoffed. I was like, what is white privilege? That is not a thing. People are crazy. Like, I literally thought that to myself.
Confronting bias has been perhaps a new teacher's greatest lesson.
I love having Timotheus in class.
Really?
He is such a sweet boy.
Really?
Really kind heart. Yes, really. You act like you don't believe me. He has moved up a ton since the school year.
But you do not knock stuff over in class.
Some of the experiences have been a little harder than others, and I've kind of caught myself in really ignorant moments. But, you know, you need that as an opportunity to grow. So,
guided by the memory of her brother, a teacher intent on creating happiness, found even more of it outside her comfort zone.
So my fiance is African American, and this is actually one of the reasons he said he was initially attracted to me, because he said, I love that you teach my people. It was such a relatability thing for him.
Perfect.
The impact that these kids have had on me and the way that they've been able to shape, you know, my view of the world and my view of the North Side and of this community, it's just been amazing. So
you,
I'm super grateful. And then we go to the bathroom, and then we go to art. Okay, great.